Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to easily synchronize audio and visuals from different sources. This is a crucial step to ensure that audio and visuals from different sources are synchronized. In professional filmmaking, you might have seen these clapping boards being used. And that's exactly how it works. Everyone, they set up all the different video camera angles, whatever cameras. They set up all the audio devices, recording devices. And once everything hits recording, they start with a clapping board. And in editing, in post-production, they then are able to match these visuals and sounds from this clapping board moment. But you guys, you don't need a clapping board. It is really, really simple. All you need to do is clap your hands. And I'm going to show you that now. I'm going to edit it afterwards in Premiere Pro. Other editing programs are very, very similar. I think iMovie I've used is very, very similar as well. So let's get started. I'm just using here my normal computer camera to film this. And here I have a handy recorder. So I hit record. I hit record, put this aside, and let's clap. And now let's go to Premiere Pro and show you how the editing is done. Really, really easy, simple. Now here you can see I've already imported the video and the separate audio file from earlier. Here you can see this is the audio file, and you can see there's a few high points, but it's mainly this high point. Let me get this closer to you so you see it. And here, this is the clap point. And so let me close it. And we just have to now match this with what I was saying earlier. So we will get here my video. Let me have a look here. You can actually see it here. So this is my video file. Let's say I put it in here into Premiere Pro. They see there's a lot of talking I did at the beginning. And here you can see the clap. You can vary. I will just show you this a bit bigger. So here you can see this is my video file, this is my face there, and this is all my talking. And then here is the clap. Okay, so what we will do is take the audio. Let me just cut this down, I will edit this later, I just want to show you. So here, take this audio file and put it underneath. And the best way to edit is by looking at just the audio. And then obviously afterwards you can look at it whatever way you like. Here, down here, you just make it larger so you can see more. You can also make it larger here. You can make this smaller so you don't see this, you don't normally need for afterwards. So here you have these two high points. This is my video file. This is the separate audio file. And with video files, you would do it exactly the same. Different video files, you would put them on top. And obviously in your editing program, it puts the audio sources on different levels underneath. You just have to find this clapping point that you have. And always remember to clap when you do this kind of thing. So make sure you clap in between. You stop recording. So let me show you. We'll just cut this a bit shorter here because this, so here you can see these points, and now I'm just matching it as close as possible. Sometimes it's not so easy, I found, but it's still okay. But look here, this is all perfectly matched now. So I could even, now let me show you, get out of here. I will turn off the audio. This is my main video audio, media and audio track. Turn it off and it should fit after the clap. should nicely match the video. Let me play.
And now let's go to Premiere Pro and show you how the editing is done. Really, really easy, simple.
So, and now this was the audio track, the separate audio track, very, very simple, as you can see. And to show you that it really worked is here, the audio is turned on. I will turn it off on the audio, separate audio track. Just show you the main track. So you can see this is where I clapped.
And now let's go to Premiere Pro and show you how the editing is done. And now let's go to Premiere Pro and show you how the editing is done. Really, really easy, simple. And now let's go to Premiere Pro and show you how the editing is done. Really, really easy, simple.
And this is how it's done. It's very, very simple. You do it in all kinds of programs like that. In iMovie, you would do it the same. In Wondershare, I think it's also DaVinci. All these different softwares, you would do it. You would align this clapping point as closely as possible. Sometimes I found there was like a step. Let me show you here. There's like a step missing, step slower. So you need to get it as closely as possible. Yeah. Let me just see. Here, sometimes it can be a little bit more tricky here with these alignments. Here you can see it's perfectly aligned, almost. You see this? It's going up the curve. And sometimes there's a bit slight different, but get it as closely as possible. It's really, really simple, and it's super, super easy to do. And I can also show you how to play it together. Same one.
And now let's go to Premiere Pro and show you how the editing is done. Really, really easy, simple.
This was now both tracks together played here. That's it. That's how it is done. So be mindful of keeping your audio and video in sync throughout your editing process. So this means checking and adjusting as necessary after each cut. And this is how you ensure that the audio video synchronize. And there you have it. Merging different sources of sound and audio is very, very simple. And exactly as I said, you do the same thing if you had different video tracks and their audios underneath. It's exactly the same thing, but it's a crucial step if you want to film different things from different angles, different sound sources. So happy filming, guys!